Hello everyone! I hope you have your spacesuits ready, because today we are going to explore how electricity is used in space. Before we take this voyage into the stars, don't forget to subscribe below. Ready? Okay, let's go! 3, 2, 1, liftoff! Whew, that was a trip. And actually, I brought someone back with me. No, not an alien, but space friend Athena. Hello Athena, what are your new space missions?
Hi Frederic, I'm happy to come back and talk about space. It's my passion, and I understand electricity is yours. Well, let's get to it. Like you said, electricity is essential to any trip in space. And many space voyages utilizing the newest electrical technologies in ship design, travel, and function. Take the International Space Station, for example.
From my understanding, the ISS electrical system is critical for providing the crew with comfort, safety, and data collection when the station is not in direct sunlight.
That's right. When away from sunlight, the station is powered by lithium-ion batteries. This is called the eclipse stage of travel and counts for about 35 minutes of a 90-minute orbit. These batteries are placed on trusses and recharge when the station is in direct sunlight. Which brings us to our next use of electricity in space. You may have seen these on a space station before, but guess what? These wings, or saws as they are called, convert sunlight into electricity and directly power the ship.
I knew they looked familiar. I know solar panels when I see them.
Space solar panels, mind you. Weighing in at 1,090 kilograms and spanning 35 meters in length, they can generate up to 240 kilowatts when in direct sunlight.
They are much closer to the sun, and without atmospheric interference, this must make the rays they collect all the more powerful. But because of this extreme heat, won't the cells gradually degrade?
Nice observation. But it's actually the variation in temperature that takes its toll on the saw cells. In one day, the temperature can range from 120 to negative 160 degrees Celsius. But the panels have decent endurance, around 15 space years. You know how long that is? Also, overheating can be an issue. That's why the spacecraft use radiators to cool down.
So tell me, how exactly does the International Space Station manage all this energy?
It has a monitoring system that controls its power intake. The system consists of a shunt unit that levels its voltage, a DC-DC converter that functions as a secondary power system, and a thermal control system that regulates temperature. But not only that, when space shuttles used to dock, the shuttle would plug into the ISS power source and recharge.
Can you tell us about some of the ISS missions?
Sure. In fact, one ISS mission was dedicated to the study of Earth's atmosphere and the positive changes of solar energy. Astronauts took an outside look in and were able to diagnose the status of our planet.
Awesome! And how about you? What advice would you give to young What's What viewers who want to work in space?
If you want to work in space, you've got to know a lot about space. So watch more YouTube videos like What's What and others about space. Read more books about space and always keep learning.
So, why is space exploration necessary for our future?
Well, think about it. If we never explored the rest of this planet and migrated to different regions, we wouldn't be so diverse in our culture and our ideas. So imagine what more we would discover when we explore beyond our planet. Well, best of luck to you future scientists out there. But me, I gotta go back to space. More things to explore out there. Bye, guys.
She's really good at that. We can't all be astronauts. Let's take a look at some other space technologies that use electricity. The Mars Exploration Rovers are robots that explore the Martian surface, mostly for biogeographical purposes. the first two rovers both outlived their life expectation in outer space. A lot of that is thanks to electricity. Let's take a deeper look. This little friend is also driven mostly by solar power, with the ability to generate 140 watts in 4 hours, which is good because he needs only 100 watts to function. But on Mars, it's not just sunlight that is a factor. Dust can block the panels and lower the solar consumption rate. Once again, batteries are installed for backup and add about 7 kilograms to the total weight of the robot design. But there are much more technologies on the rovers too. Panoramic cameras, navcams, data processors and image compressors, low-gain and high-gain antennas. You name it, I'm not going to lie. I want one of these, badly. It's not likely, but one can hope. Amazing how we've used electricity in space so far, isn't it? So, what's next? With the growing demands for energy and climate change, some suggest we launch solar power stations into space and collect our energy from out there in the great beyond. Is it possible? Many think so. As we mentioned, the sun rays are stronger in outer space. And if distributed correctly, stations could collect energy around the clock. Imagine the benefits. Not only would they reduce greenhouse emissions, but some believe a well-developed space system could generate as much energy, if not more, than a nuclear power plant. In theory, the stations would be retractable, folded into bundles, and launched into space. After which, the system would unfold and begin collecting energy from the sun, then transfer that energy to a receiver via microwaves or beams. Innovative companies are brainstorming ways to make energy generation possible in space. Scientists nowadays really shoot for the stars. All in all, electricity plays a vital role in space exploration. Both the ISS and the Mars rovers use electricity to carry out their missions. And one day, we may even generate energy from outer space. What do you think about electricity's role in space? Could we generate solar power out there in the future? Or is this concept simply out of reach? Leave us a comment below and don't forget to like and subscribe. See you next time!